Where we're headed right now is West Cliff, Colorado. We're going to be talking to a rancher there about a strange animal death.
He thinks it's connected to UFOs.
And it's a really interesting yet very scary case because whatever killed his horse, killed his cow, killed his hog, and then killed these other animals, and we don't know why they're dying.
So you go to a rancher, and he's having all these mysterious cattle deaths, and he has no idea why they're happening. Does he notice that he starts experiencing unusual activity, like right before this happens or during, or?
They've seen balls of light either a month or two before or even a couple days prior to the strange animal death. Not every case, but the majority of cases shows tie-in between UFOs and strange animal deaths, which has been the case since 1967. It's nothing new.
In the late 1960s, the United States started experiencing strange animal deaths at an alarming rate. The incidents occurred from Oklahoma to Nebraska. Animals were being slaughtered, some with bizarre incisions, and many under circumstances that defy explanation. In a span of only 2 years, 130 cases were reported in Colorado alone. Newly declassified files from 1978 allegedly reveal that federal authorities investigated a strange animal death in Taos, New Mexico. The FBI probe appears to have recovered an unidentifiable substance from the scene of mutilated animals. In that same month, in that same town, another FBI report purportedly cites evidence of a similar material, this time at the site of an alleged UFO encounter. From here, the paper trail appears to go cold.
Mr. Walker, nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
This is Heather, and she's gonna help me investigate what's going on.
How many animals have you lost?
Well, I lost the two goats, the three steer, the hog, and the mare within a week and a half died. And it's been unreal trying to get information what caused it. I fit the steer the night before, and he was up around, walking, acting normal, ate half his feed while I was standing there beside him. And the next morning, he's laying there dead. What could kill him? I don't know. You know, I've had the water checked, the grain that I was feeding him. I kept feeding my stallion, and he's, well, there he is right over there. He's the only one that survived.
And there's no signs at all of a predator killing it?
No sign of struggle?
Nothing.
I mean, very strange. The mare, when I come out and found her, she was dead. She was somewhere between 7 to 8 months pregnant. And she was to the point you could feel the colt kick. And whenever the narcropsy found out she wasn't pregnant. And there was no sign of a colt, no sign that she aborted. Where'd the colt go?
I mean, you would definitely see signs of a fetus laying around somewhere. You see blood. As far as the vet's concerned, it was never pregnant.
Never pregnant. They won't talk to me. The state vet won't talk to me.
That must be frustrating.
It is.
Yeah.
And not doing his job.
You're talking about a red flag. That was a real big one.
Yeah.
I also heard reports of strange lights seen in the area.
See strange lights all the time over these mountains. I had a light right back at my back fence. One of them pitch black nights, no moon. And it was a very bright light, talking maybe 200 yards. I picked up a rifle with a scope to see what it was. All of a sudden, light went out.
Where you saw that light, I know you lost an animal behind your house. Was that in the same general area where you saw the light?
No, this was probably another 200 yards back.
That's still pretty close, though.
Yeah.
So there is, in the past, a correlation between these strange lights and the animal deaths.
I don't know. That's the answer I'm trying to look for.
That's why we're here, right?
Do you think there might be a correlation between those lights and your animals dying?
You tell me. You sit there and watch the mountains for a week at night, and you're gonna see some strange stuff.
So this is the location that the mare was found.
Yep.
When we come back out tonight, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna scrape some snow in different areas here. Then we're gonna use our ultraviolet lights, and we're gonna look for any blood that might be still present in the area. Then we're gonna hit it with a Geiger counter to make sure that there's no radiation here. We wanna make sure it's safe for your other animals and for you. And we're gonna see if there's any type of electromagnetic fields in this area. So does that sound like a good idea?
Yeah, I'm fine with it.
All right, let's do it. This is the exact spot where rancher Walker's mare died. So first thing I wanna do is I wanna test the soil for any type of radiation. I'm looking for any type of residual substances that might have been left behind, like the cases from the late 70s. I'm inside that pack. You're gonna find a Geiger counter. Here. Picking up just a little bit of ambient here, but not enough to worry about. Since we're right here, might as well check EMF. You have the pack. There we go. Needle right now is measuring a microtesla, so that's like 3 microteslas. That's about ambient. So everything reading-wise at this point is normal. So next what we need to do is grab the light I have.
It's in here?
Yeah.
Okay.
See right here. This is a blood light. If a predator killed his horse at this location, we'll see a lot of blood in the soil. It should turn up dark. I don't see any blood. There's around 9 gallons of blood in a horse. There should have been blood at this site. So this wasn't a natural predator. What was that? That sounded like footsteps.
I can't tell.
Flashlight over there. I don't want anybody coming up on us. Could be the wind, but I mean, I didn't hear it before with the wind picking up. There's nobody over there. Just keep an eye out every now and then, just kind of like flash the light over there. Like I said, I don't want anybody walking up on us.
The animal deaths on this ranch were accompanied by reports of strange lights overhead. The team surveys the night sky, searching for evidence of a connection between the two phenomena.
Did you see the mountain range over here?
Uh-huh.
Okay, this is actually the continental divide that we're looking at. We're completely surrounded by mountains. The closest metropolitan city is 100 miles away behind me. There should be no lights out here. So we start scanning the top part using our cameras. We can start looking for any of those strange lights.
I see something over here, Chuck.
Yeah, no, that's definitely a plane. But do you see the light over there? There's something going on just over that hill over there. I'm not sure what that is. And sometimes it flashes red. Oh, now it's out.
Yeah.
You see, it's gone now. We can't see it. Now it's back again. See that? It's just going out and coming back. Now it's gone.
Yeah, I don't see it anymore.
Planes don't move like that.
The results from tonight's investigation are puzzling. Although the Geiger counter and EMF had normal readings, the unexplained lights and lack of blood in the soil remain a mystery.
I think we should call it a day.
Yeah.
What do you think?